Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Siap sunglass lagi tu.
Semua dah ada ke? Okey, bagus. Encik Faizal ada. Encik Aisyah, Nira. Ada ke?
Dr. Lo.
Ada, semua ada. Okey, bagus. Okey, ladies and gentlemen, I am very happy and excited to be with all of you at the start of our afternoon session on the first day of our two-day program. Okay, are you just as excited to meet me?
Yes.
Right. Okay, dengar Mr. Raghavan tadi yang kata tadi ke? Buat Encik Azizi yang kata tadi. Okay, so let's boost our energy. Otherwise, we will fall asleep. Kita naikkan semangat kita. Naikkan tenaga kita. Apabila saya bilang 1, 2, 3, saya minta semua serentak untuk jerit nak belajar. Boleh ke tidak?
Boleh.
Okey, bersedia. 1, 2, 3.
Nak belajar.
Okey, saya harap anak-anak anda yang di rumah tu boleh memerhatikan cara bapak-bapak dan mak dia belajar secara online supaya boleh mereka ajar guru mereka bagaimana mereka nak belajar online juga, ya. Biar kasih seronok, ya. Okey, bagus. Okey, jadi sedikit perkara saya nak kongsi sebelum kita meneruskan aktiviti kita. Okey, kembali kita ke nota saya. Okay, back to my notes. Share screen dulu. Okay, so a few tips for you when you write a report, a technical report, okay? So the first one is, yeah, the first one is for you to avoid using phrases such as I think, I feel, rasanya, pada fikiran saya. Jangan pada fikiran saya apa semua, ya. Okay, kerana ini menunjukkan anda menggunakan menggunakan penilaian subjektif, okay? I feel, rasanya, tak ada rasanya. You must believe. Okay, 100%. You must be sure. Okay, so when you write a technical report, don't use these phrases. Jangan kata I think, I feel dan sebagainya. Yang kedua, apabila anda menulis laporan, when you write a report, please remember that you are reporting something which you had done, something which you did in the past. Ya, kita melaporkan benda yang kita dah lakukan. Okay? Ha, jadi, oleh kerana benda itu telah dilakukan, maka please use the past tense. Please use past tense when you write. Okay? You are reporting what you have done. Number two. Ya, nombor dua sekali. Avoid flowery language. Number three. Avoid flowery language. Ha, jadi kita tak perlu gunakan bahasa yang berbunga-bunga. Ya. Ah, jadi kita contohnya perkataan very. Kita boleh singkirkan perkataan very daripada daripada laporan kita. Do you know that? You know that you can remove the word very? Tahu tak? Tak tahu. Ha. Okay, very ni tidak menambah kepada maksud pun. Tak ada tambah kepada maksud pun. Contohnya. Okay. Apa bezanya urgent dengan very urgent? Urgent buat bila?
Sekarang.
Urgent tu sekarang. Kalau urgent tu sekarang, very urgent buat bila?
Semalam.
Very urgent buat semalam. Bagus kau, Fifi. Okay. Okay, so very urgent buat semalam. Jadi maksudnya very urgent pun buat sekarang juga. Urgent pun buat sekarang juga. Jadi perkataan very itu tidak menambah kepada maksud kepada perkataan kita. So you don't need the word very. Jadi singkirkan perkataan very daripada vocabulary anda, daripada kosakata anda apabila anda menulis laporan. Tak perlu kata very. Boleh ke tak? Boleh eh? Kenapa kita banyak menggunakan very? Kenapa kita banyak gunakan very? Why? Kenapa?
Sit at your desk. Emphasize the statement.
You want to emphasize your statement. Okay, possible. But there's another reason why we use a lot of very.
Kurang vocab.
Equivalent of kurang sangat.
Satu kurang vocab, ya. Dr. Azwadi, apa dia?
Bahasa Melayu ada perkataan sangat.
Okay, betul juga. Tapi sebenarnya gini. Kita banyak gunakan very. Sebab semasa sekolah dulu, kita diminta untuk... Open your book please. Okay. Kita diminta untuk... Okay. Kita diminta untuk menyediakan karangan. Composition. Sebanyak 250 kataan. Bila kita dah habis tulis, kira 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 45, 246, 247. Alamak. 247. Tapi cikgu minta 200? 200 apa? 250. Tak cukup tiga. Apa kita buat?
Tambah word very.
Oh ya? Tambah word very kan? Itu lah cari. Very, very, very. Dah cukup tiga lagi. Jadi lengkaplah 250 perkataan. Itu strategi kita gunakan di sekolah untuk menambah jumlah perkataan kita. Dan kita terbau-bau hingga sekarang ada lupa pun ya. Okey, jadi oleh kerana itu ya, singkirkanlah perkataan very. Kerana perkataan very sebenarnya tidak menambah maksud kepada apa yang kita nak sampaikan, sama ada secara lisan ataupun secara bertulis. It doesn't help. It doesn't increase or add additional meaning to what you're saying. Okey, jadi boleh singkirkan ya. Kerana kita nak mengurangkan jumlah perkataan laporan dan juga email kita. You want to reduce the number of words that you use in your essay, in your report, in your email. Kenapa kita nak kurangkan jumlah perkataan? Kenapa kita nak mengurangkan jumlah perkataan kita?
Untuk kurangkan salah.
Lagi?
People don't like to read long report.
Siapa cakap tadi?
Tidak.
Kita dah covered. Okay guys. Kalau kita menerima laporan atau kita menerima email yang panjang, apa selalu kita lakukan?
Read between the lines.
Baca.
Apa selalu kita buat?
Skip. Dari point.
Dari point. Baca juga.
Skip. Baca laju-laju.
Baca laju-laju. Tapi sebenarnya apa buat?
Look for important point.
Allah, korang semua ni. Korang semua ni memang.
Ignore.
Troll je.
Ignore.
Siapa kata ignore ni?
Saya.
Okay, dia kita boleh geng. Sebenarnya kan, Malaysia, bukan kita dua je ignore. Diorang ni pun semua ignore, tak nak kaku. kan? Jadi biasa bila kita terima email, ya Allah, panjangnya kita kata tak ada masa nak baca, tunggu tengah hari nanti. Bila tengah hari pun tak ada masa nak baca, kita tunggu ujung hari. Sampai ujung hari tak ada masa nak baca juga, kita kata kita baca esok. Tak ada masa baca esok, kita kata kita simpan. Balik semalam Jumaat, hari Jumaat kita baca. Sampai Jumaat pun tak baca juga kan? Ya, dan kita kata kita nak baca hari Ahad lah apa semua dan sebagainya. Jadi kita postpone ya. Itu sebab kadang orang, setengah orang email dia berlambat-lambat dia belum buka lagi. Because of this reason ya. Jadi sepatutnya kita buka email tapi kita tak mau membuka email sebab kita terima email tu panjang. So kita nak avoid. Orang macam tu ya. Jadi oleh kerana itu ringkaskanlah apa yang anda nak tulis. Shorten and make it more precise. Use fewer words so that people are not intimidated to use. So that people are not intimidated, okay, to use the thing that you have asked them to do. Yeah, okay. Jadi oleh kerana itu, kita nak orang baca. Kalau mereka intimidated, orang tak baca. Jadi sia-sia kita menulis. No point for us to write. No point. Kalau kita tulis laporan, technical report, do you want people to read the technical report or not read the technical report?
Read.
You want people to read. Tapi kalau panjang, orang baca ke? Tak. People don't read long reports. People don't read long emails. People get intimidated. So, please take steps to reduce the number of words so that people are not intimidated and they will read your email and read your report. Okay? Jadi salah satu caranya, kalau kita nak gunakan strategi KISS, keep it short and simple, salah satu daripada strategi ni adalah untuk menyingkir perkataan
very.
Yes. Okay? Singkir perkataan very. You don't need that. Okay? And you will start reducing the number of words. Nanti saya akan tunjuk lagi perkataan-perkataan yang lain selain daripada very. Okay? So that's the first one. The third one. Okay? Avoid the word very. Yeah? Avoid the word very. Okay? And avoid flowery language. Okay, state the facts clearly. Jadi perkataan yang berbunga-bunga itu pun tidak ada, tidak perlu juga ya. Kita menulis pada peringkat korporat. Okay, ini kita dah buat tadi dah. Okay, so this is a technical report. Ignore the summary. The summary is the last thing for you to write. Summary itu yang terakhir sekali ya. Okay, tak apa. Nanti kita pergi balik ke sini. Okay. When you write a technical report, you are writing formally. So therefore, you need to learn what is formal writing. Ya, apabila kita menulis laporan, technical, kita sebenarnya menulis satu dokumen yang formal. Oleh kerana itu, kita perlu menggunakan dokumen yang formal apabila kita nak menyajikan, kita perlu menggunakan dokumen yang formal kerana laporan itu adalah satu dokumen yang formal. Jadi kita perlu tahu apakah elemen-elemen yang menjadikan dokumen kita formal. Okey, jadi yang pertama sekali, kita sejauh mana yang mungkin kita menggunakan ayat aktif. Ya, sejauh mana yang mungkin kita menggunakan ayat aktif. Okey, active voice. As far as possible, please use the active voice because the active voice is shorter. If you look at this example, okay, so if you look at this example, alright, yang atas ni adalah ayat passive. The application will be screened by the committee. Yang bawah ni adalah ayat active. The committee will screen the applications. Okay, so if you are reporting someone did this, someone did that, use the active voice. Put that person's name or the person at the start of your sentence. Jadi ia akan bertukar menjadi ayat aktif. Contohnya, siapa yang akan membuat saringan kepada mereka yang telah memohon, kepada pemohon. jawatan kuasa, the committee. Okey, jadi committee yang akan mengambil tindakan untuk buat saringan, kami committee itu yang kita letak ke depan. Okey, the selection committee be headed by Mr. Lee. Yang ini ayat passive. No, panjang. Kita tukarkan kepada Mr. Lee will head the selection committee. This becomes an active voice. Ayat active. Okay, itu using the active voice. So the next thing is avoid contraction. Avoid contraction. What are contractions? Contraction ni singkatan. Singkatan kata seperti I am instead of I am. No. So this is an example of a contraction. I apostrophe M. Okay, satu lagi. I'm represents this. I am. Mana aku punya pen ni? I am. Okay. If you refer to she apostrophe S, okay, then you are referring to she is or she was. She is or she was. Ini. Okay, she is or she was. Okay, kalau ain't, A-I-N-T, itu singkatan kepada am not. Isn't, singkatan kepada, kepada apa?
It's not.
Yeah. Kalau yang ini pula macam mana sebutan dia? A-R-E-N-T.
Aren't.
Bahasa Azlina, macam mana sebut kata ini?
Aren.
Salah. Sebutannya bukan aren. Sebutannya aunt. Macam anti.
Aunt.
Bukannya aren. Okay. Gelak eh. Okay. Jadi.
Tapi kan Cik Azmi, dekat sekolah, kita diajar contraction macam ni. Isn't, aren't, wasn't.
Okay. Guna contractionnya sebenarnya apabila kita bercakap.
Oh, okay.
Kita ni dah terbalik. Cakap, I am not. He is not. Tapi bila menulis, he isn't. Kita terbalik. Sama juga macam dalam bahasa Melayu. Puan Zalina. Dalam bahasa Melayu, ada orang Melayu kata, saya tidak mahu pergi ke sana. Ada tak? Ke Puan Zalina cakap, saya tidak mahu pergi ke sana. Macam mana Puan Zalina?
Tak pergi situ.
Tak mahu.
Saya tidak mahu pergi ke sana. Puan Sazalina cakap macam tu ke?
Saya tak nak.
Tak nak pergi sana, tak mahu pergi sana. Itu bercakap. Tapi bila kita tulis, kami tidak mahu, kan? Kami tidak dapat. Itu dalam bahasa Melayu. Kan? Kita menulis, tapi bila cakap, tak ada orang cakap tak mau, tidak hendak, tidak mahu, tak ada. Kan? Fifi pun tak kata, saya tidak mahu. Ada Fifi kau cakap tu?
Tak mahu.
Tak mahu. Jadi memanglah cikgu ajar kita. Tapi sebenarnya penggunaannya bukan secara menulis tetapi apabila kita bercakap. Menulis, kalau kita menulis secara rasmi, kita perlu menggunakan perkataan. Lengkap. Rasmi. Jangan dipendekkan, jangan diambil singkatannya ya. Okey, jadi di dalam nota ni ada senarai saya dah bagi, anda boleh lihat senarai itu. Look at the list. Macam itu saya bagi sini. Okey, salutation tak perlu sebab saya tak mengajar anda cara menulis surat ataupun email. Okey, lepas tu steps to simplify lagi satu. Avoid legal terms. Legal terms ni tak menambah kepada maksud apa yang kita sampaikan. Contohnya, we herewith enclose our check. We herewith enclose our check. Pernah dengar tak? We herewith enclose our check. Pernah dengar?
Dalam legal document.
Dalam tiga dokumen lah kan. Dalam tiga dokumen lah. Be here with and close our check. Tapi kalau kita singkir kata here with, kami melampirkan check, we and close our check. Ada menukar ayat atau tidak? Do you change the meaning of the sentence? Tidak kan? Tak. Jadi kita boleh singkir. Buat menambah kataan aja. Contohnya, the undersigned would like to thank you. The undersigned siapa? The undersigned tu kita lah. Kan yang menulis surat tu. Yang menanda tangan. Okay, tak payah kata we, under, the undersigned lah apalah. Right side, fore side semua tak payah. Eh? Jadi ini kita kata je. I thank you. Satu lagi, we hereby declare our interest. Tak payah nak declare interest. Okay, terus je. Terus saja buat terus saja beli apa yang anda nak beli, okey. Jadi tak perlu we are interested, we hereby declare our interest. Terus kata we are interested in your products. Ya. Yeah? Satu lagi, you should herein be punctual. Apa maksud herein? Bermula daripada saat ini. Anda bermula daripada saat ini perlu tepat masa. Itu boleh dimudahkan kepada anda perlu tepat masa. You should be punctual. With regards to the aforementioned matter. Wah, panjang ni. With regards to the aforementioned matter. Ini boleh diringkaskan kepada regarding the above matter. Regarding the above matter. Dari contoh-contoh saya beri ini telah menunjukkan kepada anda bahawa dalam bahasa Melayu banyak perkataan kita boleh singkir untuk penulisan kita lebih kemas. Penulisan kita lebih padat dan mudah dibaca oleh orang. Betul atau tidak? Betul kan?
Betul kan?
Betul.
Okey, bagus. Okey, bagus. Jadi, ada apa-apa soalan ke? Is there any question? No question?
Ada pengecualian ke tak?
Pengecualian tak apa?
Untuk penggunaan legal ni.
Legal ni bila kita tulis legal document, gunalah legal words. Tapi kalau kita tulis email, kita tak perlu. Tulis email tak memerlukan legal words, eh. Okay, itu je. Saya tukar screen ya. Sebentar, eh. Okey, jadi saya tukar skrin dah. Okey, bagus. Jadi sekarang tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, tiba masanya untuk anda berlatih sekali lagi. So one more round of practice. One more round of practice. Okey. Jadi saya akan tukar kumpulan anda buat kumpulan-kumpulan baru. Are you okay with new breakout rooms? Are you okay?
Okay.
Okay, eh?
Okay.
Okay, good. Jadi saya akan pecahkan anda kepada kumpulan-kumpulan yang lebih kecil, 5 semuanya. Dalam kumpulan yang kecil ini, saya ada satu tugasan kepada anda, tugasan yang baru. Okay? Tugasannya adalah untuk anda menulis conclusion to your report. Maksudnya tadi kita dah tulis dah body dia. Sekarang kita tulis pula echo-nya. Echo-nya is a conclusion, ya. Yeah? Jadi macam mana kita nak menulis conclusion kita ni? Tengok sini, ya. Yeah? Entah. Okay, okay, saya tak tulis ini. Okay, jadi cara ni gini eh. Anda telah menulis tadi cara bagaimana nak membezakan prestasi kerja. Ada dua kereta, satu elektrik, satu lagi. Kita buat dua pen. Oh, sorry, sorry. Bukan-bukan kereta, kita buat dua pen. Tak maaf eh. Kita buat dua pen. Pen A dengan pen B. Tak maaf eh. Nah, jadi kita buat dua pen, pen A dan pen B tadi kan. Nah, jadi kita dah ada hasilnya. Okay. Nah, jadi sekarang ni kita nak minta anda untuk menulis the conclusion. So what I would like you to do now is I would like you to write the conclusion. Okay. So please write the conclusion to your report. Bagaimana nak menulis conclusion dia? Kita berlakonlah. Yang mana yang tak habis tadi, berlakonlah anda dah habis, dah ada keputusan. Senang kata, pen B lagi bagus. Okay? So, semua kata, ballpoint B, pen is a better pen. Is the better pen yang lebih baik ya keputusannya. Okay. Jadi, I want you now to write the conclusion. Jadi, conclusion dia, yang ini, sekejap eh, nak highlight, nak highlighter saya ni. Okay, so, alright. Ah, jadi, in the conclusion, refer to the reasons for embarking on the project stated in the introduction. Jadi apa yang mana kita pilih ni? Kita nak compare. Ha, jadi ni, dua ni compare eh. Compare. After that, okay, so you tell us which pen was better. Which pen is the better pen, which is pen B. Okay, lepas tu, what is your recommendation? What is your recommendation? Dah tahu pen B is a better pen. So what is your recommendation to the top management? Penting lah pula ni. Siapa ni?
Beli.
Ah, okay. So the recommendation is buy. Okay. The recommendation is to buy. So yang ini. Purchase the better equipment. Okey, boleh? Boleh tak? Boleh?
Boleh, boleh.
Very simple. I want you to write the conclusion to your experiment which is yeah, you have decided, you have discovered, mendapati ya. Yeah? You have discovered that pen B, ballpoint pen B is a better pen, the ink last longer, and then what is your recommendation to the top management? Why do you need to give a recommendation to the top management? Because the top management asked you to do this experiment. Ingat tak, Sir Gavin?
Yes.
Kan? Jadi, so recommend to them which one. Tell them which one is a better ballpoint pen. Okay, so I will break your room now. So that we don't waste a lot of time. So nanti you are in the same room as you did this morning. So please write and I'll come around to see you. Okay, bye. Okay, bye Puan Tuan Azadi, Nurul Dasani. Okay, bye-bye. Bye-bye guys. Okay, Mr. Raghavan, you can start writing, and Encik Ibrahim, you can start writing this group. Start writing, eh? So what I need is the conclusion. So you have already reported the process and the experiment. So now you need to write the conclusion. Very short. Tak panjang. Okay, the conclusion is a very short one. Okay, Faiz.
Each one of us write one, is it?
Yeah.
Each one of us will write one.
No, no, group.
Oh, it's a group. Oh, it's a group. Okay.
This is the same group, right?
Ada additional members. I'm.
Ke lain?
Yeah, I think I'm in different group. I'm the one with someone else. Oh yeah.
Tak boleh different group because you all dah.
Oh, this one different group ah.
Okay, never mind. But the conclusion is the same. The conclusion is the same. Pen B is a better pen. So write in your group, yeah? Okay, because during the lunch break, some of you left the Zoom application and you came back. So therefore, Zoom has lost the record where you were. Tak tahu kat mana.
Kita dah masuk dalam group discussion ke? Still masih dalam main punya...
You are group room. Discussion ni? Ada 9 orang.
Kita macam nak combine.
Masih belum masuk. Selalunya kalau masuk kita akan join the group.
You all, sorry. You all still
Asyik semua orang keluar ni.
Okay. Raghavan, group mana tadi?
Tiga.
Three. Thank you. Yeah. Encik Faiz, group mana?
Tiga.
Okay, saya hantar. Encik Fazli, group mana Fazli?
Dua.
Okay, bye. Hafiz, group mana Hafiz?
Nombor 1.
Saya pun 1.
Hafiz, group mana? 1.
Hafiz 1.
Ada 2 Hafiz. Mana Kim?
Cik Azmi, ada 2 Hafiz tu. 1 Hafiz, 1 lagi.
Yang Hafiz Daud tu group 1 dengan saya.
Group mana? Group Hafiz, Hafiz mana?
Hafiz Daud
tadi dia dah keluar dah.
Hafiz Daud. Aku tak cari dah Hafiz Daud. Mana Hafiz Daud ni?
Hafiz Daud dah masuk grup 1.
Oh, salah grup eh.
Hafiz Ujay. Hafiz Ujay grup 3.
Hafiz Ujay grup 3 kan?
Grup 3. Okey.
Okay, saya grup 1.
Hafiz grup 1 kan? Dah memang grup 1 dah Hafiz.
Saya Ibrahim.
Ibrahim grup 1.
Saya Ibrahim yang tadi Hafiz tu dia dah pergi dah. Dia grup 1 juga.
Oh, Ibrahim grup 1.
Okay,
bye-bye.
Okay.
Mr. Kim, grup mana Kim?
Group 4.
Okay. I send you to group 4.
Extrapolate daripada 10 pages tu, daripada 10 pages and based on ink yang digunakan, kita extrapolate jadi total pages yang pen tu boleh guna pakai ialah 16.6. Macam tu lah, Dr. Loh?
Ya, betul-betul. Then sepatutnya 16.6 divided by 50 lah kan.
30 ke 20?
50.
50. Initial lah.
Initial.
Tidak. You punya berapa banyak ink you pakai? WA1 tolak WA2 kan?
Ink yang pakai. Ya. Yeah.
WA1 minus WA2.
So that means banyak berapa banyak ink yang dah dipakai? 20 kan? 20 miligram.
Ya, tapi 20 miligram tu tulis 10 page saja.
10 page saja.
Result yang akhir tu kita extrapolate tu, maksudnya based on calculation dia boleh pergi sampai 16.6 page. Tu yang betul. Itu kan?
Ya.
Kita extrapolate untuk apa ni? 16.6 ni untuk semua. Untuk 50 gram.
Maksudnya pen A tu boleh tulis total pages ialah 16.6 based on kita punya eksperimen ni.
50 miligram.
Miligram tu berat asal pen tu. Lepas dah tulis 10 pages, berat dia dah jadi 30 miligram.
Jadi maksudnya jumlah dakwat yang telah digunakan ada 30 miligram.
20 miligram dah digunakan untuk tulis 10 pages. Jadi guna formula tu, 10 pages darab initial weight over dengan reduced weight tu, after weight. Dapatlah extrapolated total pages, iaitu 16.6 untuk pen A.
Okay, 16.6.
Actually some mistake dekat number 4 formula tu.
Kan ada macam lain sikit kan.
WA2 minus WA1 dekat belakang. Belakang sikit. WA2 ya. Tukar jadi WA1 ya, macam inilah. Ini perlu betul.
Betul. Okay, so that means ball pen A is a better pen kan, yang lebih bagus kan. Okay, so write your conclusion. Okay, lepas tu cadang, bagi cadangan kepada management untuk mengambil tindakan membeli ball pen A atas sokongan ataupun atas cadangan kita, atas keputusan yang kita dapat tadi tu. Berdasarkan cadangan, berdasarkan keputusan yang kita dapat. Nah, tadi dia suruh kita eksperimen dan tengok pen mana lagi bagus kan? Kita dah tahu dah pen mana bagus, pen A.
Perlu ke start conclusion dengan in conclusion ataupun in short?
Tak perlu.
Oh.
Tak perlu. Sama juga introduction, tak perlu kata as introduction. Tak perlu lah, terus saja. Okay, in conclusion. Sorry, kena conclusion ya. Okay, apa dia?
Based on our experiment.
Boleh, based on our experiment.
Cik Azmi.
Ya, saya.
Patutkah kita cakap, kita conclude-kan yang kita punya eksperimen tu dah berjaya, was successfully carried out. Macam kita cakap ayat dia, start dia, the test was successfully carried out for pen A and pen B ke? Boleh ke kita, perlu ke kita cakap benda tu?
Boleh kalau nak.
Tapi tak boleh. Semestinya kena lah.
Because ada kalanya not successful, you cannot carry out any experiment, jadi no result. Mungkin you nak laporkan pasal contohnya management kata we want you to report back to us your finding this afternoon before 5. Jadi kita buatlah test kita apa semua, tapi by 5 pm kita tak dapat nak report because equipment broke down. Jadi kita kena report juga. Report apa? Kan? We regret to inform that we were not successful in carrying out the equipment because our equipment broke down. Our meter broke down. Tadi apa pula yang kita punya recommendation? We would like to request that the top management to allocate some fund for us to buy replacement equipment to carry out this experiment. Betul tak? Kan? Sebab dia kata dia nak pukul 5, nak laporan juga. Nak laporkan apa pukul 5? Laporkan itulah. Cannot carry out experiment. Equipment broke down. So I hope that answers your question. Okay, I'll come back to you.
Okay.
Based on our experiment, pen E.
Boleh.
Okay, apa khabar semua? Bilik ni apa khabar?
Okay.
Baik.
Sihat.
Okay.
Maybe okay, Tuan Azri boleh tengok dulu kot. Okey tak? Macam okay,
kita tengok ni. Kita baca ni. Okay, so you kata dia dah guna, dia dah eksperimen dah. Ada tak kata eksperimen ni?
Eksperimen?
Dimension study, bukan eksperimen study.
Technical study.
Oh, mungkin kita boleh letak kita punya alat tadi machine learning juga.
Technical study, betul. Technical study, sorry ya. Okay. Based, tapi boleh kan? Based on our experiment pun boleh juga kan? Based on our experiment, based on the technical study pun boleh juga. Ya. Yeah? Okay. Boleh. So, bagus. Lepas tu you kata suggest to perform cost analysis study before purchasing in bulk. Okay. Okay, jadi ini masalah dia kan? Nanti kalau dia tengok cost analysis pula, udahlah pula pen B pula, pen A pula kan yang lagi murah. Tapi pen A tak boleh pakai lama. Kan? Kejap rosak. Kan? Jadi selalunya lah, selalunya bila company suruh kita buat technical study sebagai landasan mereka nak buat satu keputusan, maksudnya keputusan tu just based on this only. Dia tak nak based on price lagi dah. Kalau dia betul. Nak based on price, tak payahlah suruh kita buat study, betul lah.
Betul.
Tapi some management bangang juga. Lepas kita buat ni, dia tengok price lagi. Patut pilih yang kita kata bagus, tak beli. Yang kita tak bagus, tak beli juga. Habis tu,
biasa. Setuju.
Setuju.
Undi. Bila sampai ke procurement, dia ambil yang paling murah je ni.
Habis tu apa so kita study?
Betul.
Sebabnya diorang sebenarnya diorang ada preference. Diorang sebenarnya kononnya lah diorang preference diorang nak beli A kan. Okay. Diorang preference dia A. Tapi diorang tak nak cakap lah benda tu bagus pasal mahal. Jadi dihantar pada kita technical. Diorang pun sambil hantar tu berdoa. Harap-haraplah diorang buat eksperimen tu diorang pun akan kata pen A yang bagus. Lepas tu nanti diorang justify lah. Oh, because technical study say pen A better pen. Although more expensive. Tapi kalau study kita kata pen B yang bagus, mana pula sekarang? Betul tak?
Betul.
Kan? Ada konflik pula kan? Macam tu lah. So sometimes diorang dah make a decision. Diorang hantar pada kita because diorang nak kita backup sebenarnya. Itu permainan diorang lah tu kan. Ya. Yeah. Tapi kita objektif, without fear or favor, kita scientific objectivity, kita lapor je yang mana lagi bagus kan, itu je.
So Cik Azmi rasa macam mana yang kita suggest perform cost analysis tu nak masuk ke tak yang masuk?
Tak payah.
Tak payah masuk.
Okay. Alright. Sebab itu bukan bidang kita lagi dah. Dia suruh kita study, buat technical study, kita lapor based on technical study dah. Itu je.
Tamat situ je. Okay.
Tamat situ je. Ya. Yeah. Lepas tu procurement team pula, commercial team pula nak fikirlah nak guna ke tak. Sebab selalunya yang bagus tu lagi mahal, selalunya lah. Kan, itu je. Ya. Yeah. Okay, so kalau dah siap bagus?
Dah.
Okay, kejap saya ada tengok satu lagi, satu dua bilik lagi eh. Dah.
Alright.
Assalamualaikum, Dr. Masita, apa khabar? Raghavan?
Hi.
Okay. From the results of the experiment, it was evident that ballpoint pen B lasts at the S.
Last longer.
Pasal dia kita gabungkan dengan ballpoint pen B satu. Okay, so last longer compared to A. In view of that, we recommend the company to purchase ballpoint pen B. Okay, bagus. Tapi selalunya masalah dia, Dr. Masita pun tahu kan, kalau yang bagus lagi mahal ke lagi murah?
Mahal.
Jangan
mahal.
Cakap pen, jangan cakap pen lah. Kita cakap lah kabel ke apa ke, selalunya yang mana?
Yang kalau mahal. Daripada segi kualiti yang mahal lah lebih bagus.
Lah mahal lah lagi bagus. Ya kan? Tapi semua kita buat technical study kan?
Betul.
Lepas tu tak nak cuma, pakai kan?
Cuma Encik Azmi, saya nak tanya, kalau orang betul-betul yang technical punya, kita recommend tu kita tak perlu macam elaborate further why kita ni eh. Kita untuk conclusion kita pun kita tak perlu nak state kenapa kita recommend untuk kita untuk concludekan sesuatu eksperimen tu.
Sorry, macam mana tu? Maksud puan, maksud doktor?
Maksudnya kita punya evidence kita lah. Maksudnya dekat atas discussion, result and discussion kita dah discuss. Tak tapi ada. Kita dalam conclusion, kenapa kita concludekan kita pilih brand B tu, kita tak perlu state eh?
Oh okay. Sebab kita only test satu parameter saja. Kita parameter kita apa, the ink aja kan.
Okay.
Tapi kalau kita ada kita test dua benda. Kalau kita test the apa tu, the durability of the ball joint. Dan juga the ink. Lepas tu kita dapat ball joint tak bagus tapi ink tahan lama. Kita cakaplah. Okay, based on the evidence from the experiment. Okay, the experiment. Okay, after conducting the experiment, we have discovered that the ink for ballpoint pen B lasts longer. Jadi kita cakap lah sebab.
Yelah sebab okay. Biasanya kalau dalam actual exercise ataupun research kita, kita kena ada buat beberapa experimental work kan.
Tapi ni kita satu kita test satu je.
Maksudnya dalam case untuk petang ni satulah, tapi untuk the actual biasanya kita akan buat beberapa parameter. So
betul.
Result conclusion kita tu kita kena masukkan lah dia punya reason dia tu kan.
Kita sadarkan reason yang bukan dia punya ball joint dia durable. Sebab dia the ink last longer. Kita kena sebut.
Okay.
Kan? Based on what? Because the ink last longer. Kalau tak tu dia tak tahu. Kita suruh dia test ink dengan ball joint. Yang mana satu sebenarnya yang bagus ni? Kan?
Cuma kalau dekat kita banyak eksperimen, conclusion dia kita kena ada beberapa reason. Lepas tu recommendation kita pun mesti juga ada ada dua ataupun tiga option lah juga kan. Maksudnya kita boleh recommend kalau nak harga tu murah macam ni. Kalau kualiti, nakkan kualiti, mungkin yang satu lagi ke lebih bagus ke macam mana tu?
Tapi Dr. Masita, yang kalau masuk harga itu dah bukan technical evaluation, itu dah commercial evaluation.
Oh, right. Okay.
Betul tak?
Sebab kalau macam case yang dalam saya punya team ni, kita dah maksudnya dalam exercise kita petang ni kita nak recommend dia kita terus beli kan?
Kita recommend belilah sebab dia kata diorang mula-mula the brief to you was the management told you we want to buy ball point pens. Okay, please make a technical study and tell us which ballpoint pen ink lasts longer.
Contoh lah, kalau kata company minta kita test, for this case test the pen kan, last longer. Untuk eksperimen ni kita test dia punya ink, dia punya durability last longer last the ink. Tapi ada lagi satu eksperimen kita buat untuk ketahanan dia.
The durability of the ball joint.
So different experiment, different finding. So but waktu part recommendation, kalau kita refer to just for that particular experiment saja, mungkin dia akan contradict dengan another recommendation from other experiment.
Betul. Okay, dia begini. First kali Hafiz. Okay, yeah, Hafiz. Yeah. First kali bos suruh kita study apa? Ada dia suruh kita study ball joint?
Tak. Untuk eksperimen ni taklah.
Tak kan? Dia cakap dia kata dia tanya ink mana yang last longer.
Yeah.
So kita test yang itu saja.
Okay.
Maksudnya dia nak buat satu keputusan berdasarkan ink aja. Dia tak nak buat keputusan atas berdasarkan benda lain kan. Tapi kalau dia kata tolong test dia punya roller ball, tolong test dia punya ink, tolong test dia punya structure, fitting dia, then banyaklah benda kita nak test kan. Lepas tu katakan kita dapat apa tu, kalau ada katakan pen A, daripada tiga benda kita test, dua dia lebih. Nanti cakaplah kita select pen A sebab dia ada kelebihan. Kelebihan apa? Ink last longer. Dia punya ball joint is more durable. Cakap
so,
macam itulah.
So, satu recommendation tu, dia boleh, kita boleh include-kan ada experiment punya result lah. Not necessarily that one.
Kalau arahannya untuk test benda-benda tu, boleh ke kita test benda yang tak disuruh dia tak disuruh test? Sebab benda tu every test this non-destruction destructive test apa semua perlu duit tau.
So maksudnya kalau katalah diperlukan untuk tengok durability dia, ketahanan all this part lah. So kita boleh masukkan sekali dalam satu recommendation lah.
Betul. Okay. Tapi as a researcher, you are guided by your instruction kan, from the management nak study apa kan.
Yep.
Maksudnya kita relate dengan scope of work kita lah.
Yes, scope of work. Kan, sebab saya ingat dulu masa saya kat Maxis dululah kan, kita nak beli apa tu, ada network equipment lah kan. So kita hantarlah network equipment ni nak test dia punya apa tu, dia punya coverage apa ke, something like that lah kan. Lepas tu kita punya engineer ni dah lepas 2 minggu pun tak boleh balik lagi result. Apa benda ni kan? Rupanya dia pergi test benda lain lagi. Banyak lagi benda dia nak test. Kita marah lah. We ask you only to test on that item only. Kan? Ni pada pandai pula pergi test benda lain. We want to make quick decision 2 minggu. Ya, you pergi test benda lain dah sampai 3-4 minggu lambat kan? So be guided with the instruction that you see nak test apa. Okay, kita pula, we must make clear. Do you want us to test other parameters? Tanya baliklah. Kan? No, only the ink. Only the ink lah kan. Tak payahlah test the durability pula lah apa kan.
Okay, faham.
Okay. Jom kita baliklah. I will close every room ya.
Memang kat rumah dah ni.
Memang kat rumah. Balik ke ruang utama.
Hey Yaman, dengar.
You welcome back. Kita balik lagi, dia akan balik sebentar lagi. Okay, welcome back everybody.
Hi.
Hi. Okay, welcome back. Jadi saya akan menyemak. Tapi sebelum saya semak, saya nak berkongsi dengan anda beberapa perbincangan atau perbualan yang saya telah sempat adakan dengan kumpulan-kumpulan yang saya sempat masuk tadi, sempat jenguk tadi. Ya. Okay, jadi pertama sekali, it's called Project Creep. Project Creep. C-R-E-E-P, Creep. Project Creep ni maksudnya kita telah diberi satu project brief tapi kita menambah-nambah kepada ujiannya. Ya, kita menambah-nambah kepada butiran dan kerjanya. Ya. Ha, contohnya kalau bini hantar pergi ke Maidin beli ikan kembung. Beli ikan kembung jelah. Ni pergi beli ikan kembung, pergi beli ayam, pergi beli mi maggi, balik satu troli, kan? Ha, so maksudnya kita dah tak ikut arahan, kita dah menambah-nambah. Okey? Ha, sama juga dengan plan tadi. So the instruction was the management has asked you minta tolong buat study dua plan ni, plan mana yang inknya boleh tahan lagi lama. So please test an experiment and tell us the result of your experiment, which pen's ink last longer. Okay, itu test ink. Jadi janganlah kita nak test the durability of the ballpoint, kan? Nak test lagi the structure of the casing apa semua tu. Itu semua dah menambah lah tu, project creep. Ya. Yeah? Jadi sebab every experiment and test one need resources, your time. Your time is not free because you are paid salary. Yeah. Lepas tu nombor dua, you may need other resources also. Mungkin nak hantar pergi lab mana-mana nak test apa semua, kan? So that one require money lagi, kan? Nanti bos kata pandai-pandai pula pergi hantar pergi test, siapa nak bayar ni? Kita suruh test ink je, ha, kan? Ha, just example lah. Eh. So, if you want to be sure, tanya balik. Boss, are you sure you just want me to test the ink and not including the ball joint? Dia kata, no, just the ink. Ha, just the ink, kita test ink je lah. Kan? Kita ikut arahan dia lah. Itu that's the first one. Ya. Yeah? Lepas tu the second one, we are technical, we are not commercial. Kita ada commercial team lain. In many organisation, dia ada technical team dengan commercial team. So, commercial team memang bangang tak tahu technical. Your technical team got nothing to do with dollars and cents. Kita purely scientific technical aja. Ha, kan? Jadi, kita jangan ambil peduli lah. Harga mahal ke harga murah, kita nak laporkan yang mana lagi bagus. Dia tanya mana lagi panjang, kita cakap mana lagi panjang. Mana lagi ringan, mana lagi ringan. Mana lagi lower power consumption, kita report yang mana lagi lower power consumption. That's all. Yeah? Because the commercial evaluation is done by another party, which is a commercial team. Okay? And we are not the expert in terms of commercial. Okay? Kita ni technical expert. Okay? Boleh?
Boleh.
Okay. Alright. So, kita nak test kan, nak tengok. Can you please post to your chat box? File you? Hantar kat chat box, saya nak tengok. Okay, thank you. Ada satu dah. Group 2 dulu, ya. Yeah? Pada ada dah. Sebenarnya in many organisation, the commercial team dengan technical team memang tak berkawan. Serius, memang tak berkawan. Kan? Kenapa? Sebab technical team selalu akan recommend yang lagi mahal. Betul tak? Suruh test yang mana dah bagus. Kita test lah. Memanglah yang mahal lagi lah bagus kan? Tapi commercial team nak apa? Nak yang lagi murah kan? Ha. Kalau nak yang lagi murah, tak payahlah tanya technical team. Belilah yang murah, betul tak? Kan? Ha, tapi tanya technical team kan? Ha, itulah. Itu masalah. Itulah kenapa technical team dengan commercial team selalu tak sebulu lah. Kan? In many organisation.
Technical team budak sains. Commercial team budak art.
Apa dia? Oh, commercial team budak art. Ha, betul. Betul. Commercial team budak social science, eh? Budak accounts. Dan saya harap tenaga is an organisation yang berlandaskan study. Setengah company, dia decide, management decide dulu baru suruh study. You faham tak? Ya, yeah? dia dah buat keputusan dah, kita nak beli pen A. Kau study pen A? Lepas tu kalau A, kalau kita kata A bagus, okey. Ah tu aku dah kata dah A bagus. Kita beli. Jadi dia ada technical team dah bagi sokongan lah. Jadi dia bolehlah beli. Dia memang nak A pun. Tapi kalau tak dapat A, dia kata pen B yang bagus. Eh, boleh tak kau adjust sikit? Dr. Masita boleh tak tolong adjust sikit? Ni nombor ni, ni nombor ni adjust sikit. itu keputusan dibuat sebelum study. Ada juga. Kan? I hope I think TNB is not like that lah kan. Tapi ada some companies yang I pernah jumpa, dia boss buat decision dulu. Lepas tu yang lain ni, yang buat study ni, nak backup keputusan. That's not very good, ya. Yeah? Jadi orang yang buat keputusan ni, yang buat study ni selalu kena adjust. Macam-macam lah kena adjust. Nak tunjuk yang boss punya pilihan tu betul. Okay, itu memang merugikan lah, ya. Yeah? Okay, saya tengah buka satu ni. Assignment 1. Eh, bukan ini. Faik, Faizal, Sazalina dulu ya.
Encik Azmi, please apa ni, go through sampai bawah.
Sampai bawah ni? Ni ke?
No. Ada atas sikit. Sorry.
Ni eh? Okay.
Because we just continue from the scene.
Okay. Dah dapat dah. Cuma kena tutup ni je. Okay, so ni group 5 I think. Okay, group 5, conclusion. Based on the experiment conducted, TNBR identified that ballpoint brand A showed a 10% longer writing distance than brand B with a standard deviation of 2.5%. Oh, hebat betul. Okay, brand A showed 100 meters more than brand B with high quality and clarity of the ink observed on the paper. Okay, yang saya nak komen sini pula ya. Eh. Yang you kata high quality and clarity of the ink observed on the paper. Yang ini, by the way, you didn't do additional test. Betul tak? Betul tak?
Betul.
So this is just observation by the way. Tu boleh. Sebab kaedah tu nanti boss, I didn't order this test. Dia cakap I didn't order this test. Okay. Therefore, it was recommended to TNBR management to purchase ballpoint brand A. Maksud it was recommended tu maksudnya you recommended to the management dulu. You recommend dulu ke you recommend sekarang?
Sekarang it is
Sekarang. Okay. Yes, sekarang. So therefore it is recommended. Bukannya it was recommended. So ini tukar kepada it is recommended. Therefore it is recommended to the TNBR management to purchase ballpoint brand A. However, this experiment does not consider other factors such as does not tu sekarang. Experiment tu dah buat belum?
Dah. Was not.
Oh, tonggak terbalik ni. Past tense dengan present tense ni. Aduh. Okay. Ingat. Dah buat. Dah buat kita melaporkan. Yang melaporkan, did. Yang kita buat sekarang, kita recommend. Itu is. Okay. So, this experiment did not consider other. Bukan the other. Other factors saja. Other factors. Such as mechanical failure and human behavior that will affect the pen performance. Yang ini past tense lagi. That would affect the pen performance. Masa kita eksperimen tu lah. Okay, so
would, adalah limitation.
Good. Limitation, In the future, it is suggested for the experiment to include ink variety, i.e. red and blue and other types of papers. This improvement reduces the uncertainty and increases the result confidence level. Okay. Tak payah in the future because your suggestion tu memang for the future. So keep it short and simple, Okay, so it is suggested for the experiment, bukan for the experiment, tetapi it is suggested that the experiment to include, tak payah dia sini, ink variety that is red and blue and other types of paper. I think bukan it as ni, ini for example ni. Kalau for example bukan IG, for example is EG,
EG.
Okay. IE tu, itu Greek untuk that is.
Jadi, such as.
Bukan. To that is. Such as tu sama macam for example lah. Tu EG. Exemplary Gracia nama dia,
Okay.
So yang ni EG, Contohnya, contohnya. So, sebenarnya contohnya lah. Yang IE tu, iaitu. Master Rider, iaitu. So contohnya, red and blue and other types of paper. Red and blue. So, you kena ada comma sini lah. Kaedah tu kita ingat tu other types of papers tu pun contoh you juga.
Example.
So the example tu is red and blue tu example of ink variety. So dah habis dah tu comma and other types of papers. Other types of paper kita ada S ni This improvement This improvement mungkin kita tak tahu lagi. May reduce the uncertainty and increase may increase the result confidence level. So very good conclusion. I like this. Siap dengan ada standard deviation lagi. 2.5%, and 10%, very good. Very good, group 5. Any question? Group 5?
Bila kita buat recommendation dengan conclusion ni, kita kena very careful dengan macam tadi lah, recommendation we are proposing for the future kan. So bila kita dah, masa kita conduct tu dia mostly past tense. So yes, bila recommending tu kena make sure yang kita guna present tense.
Betul. Bila kita recommend, kita guna present tense. Okay. Tapi bila kita melaporkan keputusan, melaporkan apa tu, method kita apa semua, yang itu kita gunakan past tense. Okay. Yang ini kumpulan mana pula ni? Design of the experiment. Design of the experiment ni kumpulan satu ni, I think. Okay. Okay, so ini mana your conclusion. Okay. So based on our experiment, brand A showed better performance when compared to brand B by 0.8 pages. Therefore, we recommend that the management to buy ballpoint pen of brand A. Okay, cuma susun sikit lah. Jadi brand A, ballpoint pen. Okay. Jadi kita buang ni. Lepas tu pula, we recommend the management. Okay, yang ini. Okay, showed better performance. Brand A apa ni? Performance apa ni? Rollerball or ink? Okay, brand A. Ballpoint pen ink. Okay, so based on our experiment, brand A ballpoint pen ink showed better performance when compared to brand B by 0.8 pages. Therefore, we recommend the management to buy brand A ballpoint pen. Seriously, by 0.8 pages only. So the difference between each pen is only 0.8 pages, not even one page. Is that what you're saying? Group one.
The result boleh nampak kat atas tu.
Okay, boleh. Okay, tengok So that means beza antara pen A dengan point B hanyalah 0.8. Not even one page, yeah.
Based on experiment.
Okay lah. Maksudnya benda ni macam not significant je kan. Beza dia tak sampai satu kesurat pun, ya. 0.8 ataupun 80% of a page. Okay, tapi still result is a result, ya. Okay, so thank you very much. Okay, tepukan kepada kumpulan ini. Okay, next group. Group 4. So group 4, masih lagi. Mana group 4 ni? Kita tekan lah. Okay, got it. Okay, group 4. The following conclusions can be drawn from the study. To begin with, this study has shown that volume for pen B is higher compared to pen A of 40%. Ni volume apa? Ink volume ke apa ni? What volume are you talking about? Group 4.
volume.
Yeah, betul. A volume.
Oh, so pen B volume is 40% more than pen A. Okay, so by 40%, bukan of 40%, ya. Yeah? By 40%. In addition, pen A used 0.05 milliliter to draw 10 meter of line compared to pen B, which used only 0.02 ml. Point pen B lagi. Okay. 10 meters. Ada S, ya? Further, the flow rate of pen A is higher, which is higher, which is 0.3 milliliter per second compared to pen B at 0.2 milliliter per second. Okay, bagus. The results of this study indicated that pen B lasts longer compared to pen A. However, this study is limited to ink performance only. I like this. This is good. Further study could also be done on ink quality. Itu your recommendation lah. So do further study. This is your suggestion, ya. Yeah? Okay. Okay, bagus. Very good. Okay, whenever you have a question, immediately stop me, yeah, and ask.
Just me, I just want to ask, in the line 3, the use of further as a connector tu boleh ke ataupun furthermore?
Okay, mana dia? Jom, ya.
Further, the flow rate of pen A is higher.
Jom, ya. Okay, you were saying further.
Further. Sebab further ni for distance, right?
Correct. Yeah, you're right. So add furthermore ataupun moreover. Yeah, you're right. Thank you for pointing out to me. So either furthermore, moreover, additionally, dah ada, in addition dah ada dah. Okay. So furthermore. Okay, correct. So I need to retrieve another one. Mana yang belum lagi ni? Senyum-senyum means it's true.
Cik Azmi nak tanya.
Ya.
Dari segi formatting kan, untuk conclusion, mana yang lebih better kita buat dalam apa tu? Paragraph ataupun straight away dalam bullet form?
Okay. Apa tu, there's no specific format. Yeah, there's no specific format, so it's up to you to choose which one, unless your organization has a specific format. So kalau tak ada specific format, maksudnya kita terima je lah, asalkan jelas. Okay?
Okay. Yeah? Thank you.
Okay. Okay, you're welcome. Okay, I'm opening group 3 conclusion. Okay, group 3 conclusion coming. Okay, can you see? Ballpoint in comparison testing. Okay, ballpoint in comparison testing.
Testing. Encik Azmi, bawah ini lagi. yang lama.
Betul, tadi ya, tadi punya. Tadi. Okay, conclusion. From the results of the experiment, it was evident that ballpoint pen B lasts longer compared to A. Recommendation. In view of that, we recommend. Tak payah in view of that, tak apa. To keep it short and simple, ya. Yeah? Okay, straight away, we recommend the company to purchase ballpoint pen B. Okay, short and simple. All right. Okay, well done, everybody. Clap. Okay, so any question? Any question? Tadi siapa tadi, grup mana tadi yang tentang diagram, picture dengan dengan figure and table. Okay, so I've made my references. Okay, for academic writing, yeah, for academic writing, so meaning at the university when you write for your, when you're writing your thesis, okay, there's only two. One table, the other figure. Okay, so you either choose table or figure. Dia tak ada chart apa semua, tak ada. Okay, so table, table means a table containing data. Okay, either numbers or text. So that is table. So you label table 1, table 2, table 3, a list of items, okay? Yang mana yang ada gambar-gambar, diagram dan apa semua tu, all fall under figure. So the labeling is figure. Figure 1, figure 2, figure 3. Okay? Jadi tak ada picture, tak ada diagram, tak ada chart. So that is for academic writing. Okay. However, for non-academic writing, yeah, for non-academic writing, you have some freedom. So it's up to you. Yeah, you have some freedom, it's up to you. So you can choose. Because as I said earlier, yeah, technical report writing falls under the gray area. The gray area between formal and informal. Okay, it is not formal as if it is to be presented for publication in journals. It's not good enough for journal publication. Yeah, and it is more complicated than just a simple report. So therefore, you can you have to write formally, but the rules are relaxed a bit when it comes to the labeling of your diagrams, your charts, as well as your tables. Okay. Yeah. Okay. All right. So now time is 3:40. Yeah. So what I'm going to do now is I would like to request that all of you break into new groups. I'm going to assign you new groups. Kumpulan baru. Okay, kumpulan baru semuanya. Okay, and this time the task is for you to test, okay, to recommend to the top management, right, which transformer oil to be used, to be purchased. Okay, bagi choice, okay, Hyrex and Shell. Okay, transformer oil, brand Hyrex and brand Shell. So itu je. So the management has not suggested what parameters even. So it's for you to decide what is the important parameter to be used for management decision. Is it the viscosity? Is it the viscosity? Is it the specific gravity? Is it the flash point? Or is it the moisture level? Right? So decide on one parameter and then pretend to test and get the result. And for your test, okay, I would like to suggest to cut short the time, send it to third party testing. Okay, send the sample to third party, to a third party lab for testing and report the result. Okay lah. Okay, understand?
Boleh ulang balik tak?
Okay. Management nak pilih antara dua brand transformer oil. Tahu transformer oil? Dan transformer tu kan ada minyak kat dalam tu. Okay, ya. Jadi ada dua brand. Satu brand Hyrax, satu brand Shell.
Hyrax tu H-I-R-A-X.
Nah, I think lah. H-I ke H-Y. Okay. Okay, lepas tu the management bagi cakap macam tu je. Nak, kita nak pilih nak pakai antara dua ni. Mana satu, mana satu yang patut kita pilih? So that's why you need to recommend to them. But they did not tell you. Macam tadi dia kata, please test the ink. Tapi kali ini, the management didn't tell you what to test, what parameter to test. So you have to recommend to the top management what is the most important parameter for a transformer oil. What is the most important parameter for transformer oil?
Moisture content.
Tak tahulah. Ya, mungkin doktor masih tak tahu. Okay. Yang lain tu fikirlah. Okay. Dia ada banyak parameter. Minyak banyak parameter. Specific gravity, flash point, viscosity. Moisture control. Moisture content. So apa antara ni, apa yang penting?
Kita nak satu parameter je ke, ataupun kita boleh recommend kat management at least 4 parameter to analyse dekat third party ke macam mana?
Okay, kalau nak analyse boleh lah. 4-4. Tapi apa yang penting? Apa yang penting? Is specific gravity important or not for transformer oil? I don't know.
Okay? 4 lah kan?
Okay, kalau satu-satu lah, it doesn't matter lah. Satu-satu lah, because akhirnya you are going to write. Okay, the activity is a writing activity. Okay, nak cut short, tak payah buat eksperimen. Kali ni, hantar pada third party lab. Hantar pada third party lab. Apa test dia buat kat third party lab tu? Kan? Lepas tu, what is the result? What is the result and what is the conclusion? So it's just the body. Okay, just the body. Okay, body je. Conclusion tu kemudian, body je dulu. Okay, so I'll break you into your group, yeah? New rooms. Okay, I've created the rooms and I'm going to open the rooms. So I'll see you in your rooms. Bye-bye. Bye-bye-bye. Bye Akmal. Bye Dr. Masita. Okay, bye Mr. Raghavan. Kaide, bye Kaide. Zalina tak pergi join. Fazli.
Ken, I don't know. Sebab dia ada banyak faktor lain kan.
Betul lah.
Hai Cik Azmi.
Hai. Okay.
Keeping Tom.
Mentam je lah apa-apa parameter pun. Okay. bukannya tujuan saya nak test your scientific knowledge.
Knowledge, okay.
Tamnya. Because I want you to write. I want you to practice writing, eh?
Okay.
Okay.
Installation,
kot. Layan ni, I tengok kat Wikipedia. These are testing oil quality.
Perbezaan voltage ke? Tu pun tengok.
Kalau kita betul-betul nak faham, guna minyak ni dalam transformer sebagai alat penebat. So that tak ada apa tu electricity apa, kau panggil arc, ya. Yeah. Ya, antara dua point tu kan, dia tak ada bersambung macam tu. Ha, dia penebat.
Okay.
Insulation. Dia macam insulation. Ha, kan? Kau ingat dia ada short circuit kat dalam transformer tu. Jadi kalau kita tahu benda tu penebat, jadi apakah yang paling penting?
Okay.
Water content.
Water content.
Mm-hmm. Moisture content. Betul.
Okay. Moisture content kena rendah lah.
Betul. Dia kena very dry. Ya, kalau water boleh meletup pasal dia ada, boleh bersambung, elektrik tu boleh pintas, ya. Yeah? Okay, I'll come and join you guys later. So bagus ni. You dah senaraikan semua parameters oil.
Faik rasanya dia kena ada lagi satu kolom tambahan sebab kita nak compare hyrax dengan shell, kan?
Bagus. Okay, tapi tak semua tu penting.
Betul. Cuma kita orang list out dulu and then nanti discuss yang mana kita akan ni lah.
Okay, saya bagi tip, ya. Okay, gunanya transformer oil dalam transformer sebagai penebat. Supaya elektrik tak melompat dalam transformer tu, dia tak melompat. Ada dua pillar tu, dia tak melompat. Jadi apa yang penting?
Electrical testing.
Apa elemen kat sini yang akan mempengaruhi kuasa penebat?
Breakdown voltage.
Apa? Is it the flash point? Flash point tu dia nak bagi tahu pada tahap suhu berapa dia akan tiba-tiba kembas, yang tu kembas, eh, berapi terbakar. Itu flash point. Okay, bagi tip lah. Moisture content is the most important one. Tak boleh ada air. Ada je moisture, dia akan meletup. Ya, sebab bila ada moisture, maka ada apa tu, elektrik tu dia akan melompat dari satu pilar ke satu pilar, eh, dia akan melompat. Itu yang buat meletup tu transformer. So that is the most important parameter for transformer oil.
Okay.
Untuk assignment ni kita tak buat study, eh. Maksudnya kita propose parameter apa yang kita sepatutnya
propose, lepas tu hantar ke lab test.
Ke lab for test lah.
Sebenarnya all the oil companies pun produk dia dah bagi dah specification dia, tapi kita kena verify lah. Nanti yang tadi tu ada satu tu kita test antara dua produk, satu lagi tu verify the claim, kan? So you need to verify the claim.
Yes.
Betul. So, Antalab. Kalau you nak eksperimen, you kena beli alat gas spectrometer.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Then lagi satu rasanya this one kalau kita assume dah type test, kalau minyak ni dah type test, biasanya yang critical moisture je lah. Yang satu dengan tiga tu biasanya pass lah.
Ah, betul lah. Moisture is the most important parameter lah. Betul lah tu.
Okay, so sebab, kita fokus satu je lah.
Boleh. Sebab apa tu? Sebab transformer oil ni digunakan untuk sebagai bahan penebat dalam transformer.
Cik Azmi, yang term dia moisture.
Yeah.
Moisture content tu memang dia pattern untuk oil dalam oil eh.
Untuk lubricant lain not critical. Tapi dalam transformer oil must be very dry, kosong.
Sebab tak nak effect paper kan.
Dia kalau dia penebat dua ada dua tiang kat dalam transformer tu. Dia macam ni. Jadi kalau ada water dia akan melompat tau. Dia elektrik tu akan melompat lah. Kan? Jadi tu boleh meletup lah tu transformer tu.
Betul lah.
Okay, so so that's why water content is the most critical specification for transformer oil.
Water content lah dalam oil tu.
Yes. Water content ataupun moisture content lah. Okay. Dan tak payahlah nak buat test kat dekat pejabat. Yang ini banyak commercial lab boleh buat. So, hantar je commercial lab. Tunggu result, report the result.
Send to the third party, accredited laboratory lah.
Tapi cerita lah sikit kenapa in your point of view that the moisture content is the most important parameter. Sebab management bila dia tak bagi direction, apa nak jadi, maksudnya dia orang pun tak tahu. Okay, so you kena tulislah sikit. Why the most important criteria or the most important specification is the moisture content
specification. Okay. Okay, alright.
Okay, nanti kita datang
Sekejap saya.
Saya pun dah lupa dah dia punya measurement dia apa. Ke percentage? Saya pun tak ingat lah.
Dia ada dua. Report dalam percentage boleh, report dalam PPM pun boleh, tak silap.
Betul lah tu, moisture content. Sebab dalam transformer oil ni gunanya sebagai penebat, supaya ada dua tiang dalam transformer oil tu, dan transformer tu dia tak melompat lah elektrik tu. Okay, yang lain tu color index tu that's not important lah. Yeah. Dielectric breakdown maybe important. You can justify. Sebab maksudnya the breakdown of the oil molecules when you apply electrical charge. Yeah. Okay, you're on the right track. Lepas tu tak payah eksperimen. Hantar ke lab terpati banyak . Tapi management tak tahu apa yang the important specification. So you need to educate also. So educate your top management that the most important element in a transformer oil is the moisture content. Bagi tahu sebab je kenapa tu sikit .
I'm just sharing.
Where did you get this test result?
This is a list of tests yang PNPR Transformer Oil Lab is currently doing.
Yeah. So you are in charge of the testing.
No, we have a project. We have a project with Transformer Oil Lab, and then we have them to build some algorithm, analytics.
Okay.
so we have access to their database.
Okay, so I think you know lah, the most important specification is the moisture content, eh?
Moisture content, dielectric breakdown, and so on. This is the filter.
Okay, so you're on the right track. You see, when I gave you the brief just now, I said the management didn't indicate what test is important. Didn't direct you to do any test, no specific test. So that means the management, the top management, does not know which test is important. So we have to inform them that the water content or moisture content is the most important specification for transformer oil. So that is why you have sent the sample for testing for moisture content. Yeah.
So you should include the reason why you choose.
Is it why you choose to test for moisture content?
Kalau tadi dia kata perlu kan?
Macam mana?
Kalau tadi dia kata macam tak perlu kan?
Tapi kita nak kalau tak nak buang, kalau nak kena state lah kenapa kita pilih color tu.
Color pun ada ni eh, ada impact eh, maksudnya
color ni biasanya orang hantar sebab murah.
Oh,
adalah impact dia tapi murah kan. Oh, maksudnya macam dia kita senang nak tengok kalau dia darken maksudnya dia kotorlah, dia
kotorlah, tak lagi tak eloklah
sikit, dia ada contaminant untuk aking. Pun boleh juga kita nak bagi reason sebab dia mudah.
Lagi simplelah.
Saya rasa okey kalau kita nak masukkan.
Maksud ini secara visual.
Tapi yang dua kertas tu memang penting. Maksudnya moisture dengan dielectric breakdown tu memang wajib, biasanya basic kita hantar. Color ni sampingan, biasanya orang akan hantar je sebab dia visual inspection. So kalau color tu tak okay and then kita nampak dia memang gelap more than fine, dia contribute untuk nak arcing tu yang akan further lagi kita buat dissolve gas analysis lah apa semua tu semua lah, lagi detail lah.
Dahsyat. Saya pun dah tak ingat dah semua specification. Dr. Masita, are you in charge of the testing of oil?
Masa saya baru join, saya buat transformer oil lebih kurang dalam 5 tahun. Sekarang ni saya dah tak buat dah, Cik Azmi.
Saya dah 25 tahun tak buat, lagi lah lupa.
Tapi biasanya basic parameter yang kalau nak murah tu 3 tu memang wajib lah. Lepas tu baru go further.
Saya seriously saya tak ingat yang color index tu. Saya cuma ingat moisture content dengan dielectric breakdown, itu yang saya ingat.
Sebab color tu dia murah dan mudah nak buat. Lepas tu dia boleh detect arcing tu, nak tengok arcing punya problem.
Tapi saya tanya, sebab tenaga banyak guna transformer oil. Tenaga tak ada ke dalam lab apa tu gas spectrometer nak test sendiri?
Ada memang kalau dekat TNBR dia memang ada transformer oil lab tu, dia memang one of the best lab dekat Malaysia untuk nak buat transformer oil test lah.
Oh, memang ada lah. Okay, tapi tak payah test lah. Hantar nak cepat penulis ni, hantar je pada
kiranya macam kami kiranya itu third party jugalah sebab dia anak syarikat kepada TNB Research. Dia panggil TNB Labs.
Maksudnya kita hantar sampel pada dia orang lah.
Hantar sampel pada dia orang, bukan research buat sendirilah.
Jadi tak payahlah kita nak report methodology pula kan.
Betul.
Yang standard tu that means lab tu yang accredited, lab tu dah ada lah. Tak payahlah kita
cuma kita instruct dekat lab tu guna ASTM standard. Biasanya diorang nak ASTM standard kan?
Betul, ASTM, yes. Okay. You're on the right track. Tapi yang ini tadi, awal tadi, management tak bagi arahan suruh test spesifikasi apa kan. Jadi maksudnya maksudnya management ni blur lah bangang, dia tak tahu benda satu. Jadi you have to educate them. Jadi kena tulis lah kenapa yang dua ni atau tiga ni yang dipilih untuk diuji ya. Lepas tu apa result dia ya.
Maksudnya reason kenapa kita recommend tu lah. Itu early punya, untuk prelim punya result better hantar yang tiga ni lah.
Yes. Kenapa? Cakaplah moisture tu kenapa? What is the effect of moisture content? Okay, dielectric.
Kira-kiranya testing justification ni naik dekat atas. Kim?
Okay. Nanti I will come around ya.
Lepas tu unit dielectric breakdown ni KV, bukan millivolt amp ni. Saya rasa KV.
Kita letak dalam testing lah.
Mana dapat ni? Mana dapat table ni?
Kita Google lagi.
Journal.
Hah?
Ni dari journal ni.
Mana? Semua tu saya sebut tadi kan? SG, flashpoint. Okay. Betul lah. Betul. Nah. Okay. Tapi don't buy equipment to do test. Okay? Just send to apa tu? Third party lab.
Third party.
Cuba.
According to the standard ni lah kan.
Dia ada standard dia. Dia accredited. Yes. So, dia STM tu accredited lab lah. Cuma tadi management didn't indicate to you what test to do kan.
Yeah.
Jadi maksudnya management tak tahu. Management tak tahu. They don't know what is important. So you have to write a little bit in your report to tell them why, to justify why you are selecting these few tests, satu atau dua tests nak buat comparison between Shell dengan Hyrex.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Tak payahlah test semua. It's okay. Tak payah test semua. Ya, acid value tu tak ada kena-mengena pun. Ya, acid value tu untuk apa tu, corrosion. Tak ada kena-mengena dengan transformer oil ya. Okay.
Okay. Okay, from here yang mana IFP ya? Interface tension tak ada ke sini?
Nak buat body ke kita nak buat conclusion?
Buat body ke buat conclusion?
Body.
Body kan? Maksudnya benda tu kena ada dalam body lah sekarang.
Oh, korang dah sampai conclusion dah. Okay lah, dah sampai tu. Sampai lah conclusion tak apa. Tapi you need to also write in your body why you are selecting to test moisture content and breakdown voltage. Sebabnya management tadi dia tak cakap, macam tadi pen dia suruh okay test the ink. Yang ini tak ada. Dia kata test the two oil. Kan? Jadi kenapa kita pilih these two tests? Sebab management tak tahu kenapa. So you have to tell them why. So that's your challenge tu. That's your challenge, ya?
Yeah? Tapi still kena ada recommendation lah kepada management.
Nah, itu dah ada dah. Tak apalah tu. Dah ada kat bawah tu. You dah recommend lah tu. Oh, bukan. Itu I baca sekarang. You recommend the transformer to be tested by TNB Lab. Ingat you dah recommend either Shell or Hyrex. So belum lagi.
Belum. Belum lagi. Baru pilih parameter apa yang kita nak submit ke lab lah for testing.
Okay. I understand. Okay, continue ya.
Tak masuk lagi lah.
Water content. Water content miligram per kilogram. Ada data sheet yang jumpa dekat online.
Ada, boleh share.
Ada miligram per kilogram kalau water content lah. Yang lain tak siap.
dia PPM kan, water content and transport air untuk PPM.
Dia depend, dia sama ada PPM atau apa percentage. I tak tahu which one. Kat spesifik sheet tu ya.
Viscosity.
Dia punya pass fail apa?
Apa dia?
Dia punya pass fail berapa? Yalah, value pass untuk pass
fail. I tak ingat. I tak ingat dah. I tengok dah berapa, 1% ke less than 1% dia tak boleh langsung. It must be very dry.
Oh, so apa lah table tu kita kata pass fail je lah. Boleh ke?
Tu gantilah. Saya bukan saya nak test you punya scientific knowledge. I'm not here to assess your
kurang scientific
knowledge. Hantam ya, okay?
Alright. Okay. Boleh tulis pass fail je lah. Dia punya result. Analisis test result kan, pass fail je lah, satu pass satu fail.
Kira semua, tulis semua ke ya, moisture level je kan?
Nak test moisture level. Nak test viscosity juga?
Macam mana?
Nak test viscosity juga ke? Viscosity tu penting ke?
Tak, kita tak test. Kita kata important parameter dalam form oil tu termasuk
kita stay je.
Kita select.
Okay. Kan. Viscosity ni ke pekatan dia. Kan? Ke likatan dia. Tu tak penting. Engine oil penting. 30, 40, 50, 50 lah. Tu viscosity lah tu. Okay. You're on the right track.
Macam ni saja boleh Encik Azmi. In point macam ni ke nak dalam paragraph? Tak kisah.
The more relevant question is, is this enough to convince the top management? Itu je. Aku pun tak tahu you punya top management macam mana.
You should know your top management. Okay, top management kita orang terima benda je ni. Okay,
terima. Dia pass fail terima. Terima lah. Kan? Pelik juga pasal you all punya top manager mestilah engineers. Boleh juga macam ni. Okeylah. Pass fail.
Okey. Nanti kita tambah sikit lagi kot.
Okey. Selalunya kalau engineer ni nak sangat tengok figure dia, nanti dia tanya figure kan.
Lalu
kan. Okey, continue guys. Continue nanti kau datang eh.
Alright, okay, thank you.
Okey.
Data collection analysis.
Reports from external labs summarized as
Dr. Low, your group is the most technical group for this session.
Kita Google saja Wikipedia.
Okay, you dah tengok Wikipedia tu lagi all the test.
Okay.
Reports of the test are summarized as below.
Sampai sini je lah kot. Nak tambah data dah ada. Nak buat analisis ke limitation
perlu lah. Sebab accredited sudah kan test lab tu.
Oh, analisis
Table 2 punya label kena refer
kat daripada atas tu. Main parameter tu kita kat atas. Dia pun kat bawah tu. Macam tu. Kan? Nampak
kemai.
Nampak gitu. Flow dia lah.
Kan? Kita tak payah letak main, kita cakap parameter to be tested.
Tapi kalau DGA tu tak payah ke?
DGA tu perlu, tapi kalau benda tu dah lebih-lebih tu nanti dah teruk sangat, barulah buat DGA tu. Ni kalau macam result 1.5 ni memang minyak baru ni.
Oh, entry requirement lah.
Pasal minyak absorb moisture from the atmosphere.
So kalau moisture content dia kita letak rendah, dan electric breakdown pun mesti rendah juga. Sebab dia ada interrelated.
Yang itu kan more than 35 kilowatt ke?
Correlation.
Kilowatt.
More than kan?
More than ke?
Doktor, nak tanya kalau kita buat ni, dia tak ada uncertainty level lah doktor. Maksudnya
ada
plus minus berapa?
Boleh. Buat je lah plus minus 0.01 ke.
So that kita boleh accept within that percentage of uncertainty.
Sekarang ni kan, kita kan tengah kelas je. Result yang kalau hantar kat lab memanglah ada plus minus tu saja. So kalau kita nak tulis kat situ, tulislah plus minus 0.0 berapa?
Ah, ha ha, 0.05. Tinggi sangat.
Oh, bagus juga ya. Kita buat kelas macam ni ya. Jadi siapa yang tak tahu apa-apa tentang transformer oil pun dah tahu dah tentang transformer oil kan?
Dia bukan macam itu, Kim tulis je. Tu dekat result tu, high rate plus minus 0.01. Dia punya
1 to perform
to ETOT.
Okay. Perform the 3 tests. 3 tests shown above. To a third party at a we just say ETOTS lah. Labs. Okay. So we have sent out the samples to perform the 3 tests as shown above at ETOTS labs.
Apa tu? ETOT tu apa? What is ETOT?
ETOT tu nama lab. Actually, it's the name of the company lah. The testing company.
Oh, okay.
Ataupun kita sebut je lah accredited ATSM lab je lah kot.
Boleh.
ASTM. ASTM. Okay, tak apa.
Accredited.
Testing laboratory.
ASTM back boleh kot. Apa tadi?
Tak payah ASTM. Kita buat accredited. Okay.
Lepas tu yang peragaan kedua yang similar ni, high BDV tu kan?
Boleh sambung tak tu? Kena naik kat atas.
Boleh lah, boleh je. Nak naik pun boleh, letak situ pun boleh. Okay je, nak naik pun tak apa. Combine terus jadi satu kan?
Jadi satu peragaan.
Apa yang kita suruh TMP Labs buat tak specify ke? Tak nak detail out ke?
Macam mana?
Testing dia ke, doktor?
Ke cukup sekadar kata kita test moisture content secara general macam tu je?
Tu lah kat situ maybe ada benda yang missing sikit eh. So
sebenarnya
nak detail out kat situ. Kita letak apa tu, standard apa yang kita follow.
Sebenarnya bila kita hantar sampel pergi testing kat lab, dia akan balik macam kita punya apa tu blood test result semua sekali semua keluar kan. Jadi jadi it's a package. Jadi tak ada dua aja sebenarnya, tapi kita nak indicate to the top management daripada banyak-banyak tu apa yang menjadi faktor penting, which is which one should be our decision criteria. Betul tu, dua tu betul tu.
Tak cukup ke emphasize macam tu ke management tak puas hati lagi?
Dia kena explain lah kenapa, apa apa pentingnya moisture content parameter tu, apa pentingnya breakdown voltage parameter for transformer oil. So explain to them. Explain to them why it is important. These two. Yang lain tu less important. Yeah. Viscosity, specific gravity, semua, all those are less important. Tapi dah ada lah network ni, ada lah minimum value breakdown voltage is 30 to 40 depends upon the moisture present in transformer oil. Yeah. But is this enough? Can they understand? So these are the questions that you need to ask.
Which much more better than Hyrax?
Oh, tak.
Yeah. Which much more better? Banyak pula. Which better je? Which better je?
Tak ada much more better. Better je.
Salah. Encik Azmi masuk dia salah.
Better tu dah maksudnya lebih baik. Tak payahlah lebih baik. Banyak kali lebih.
Aje nak lebih baik. Aje nak Encik Azmi tadi. Saya tahu Encik Azmi nak masuk.
Okey.
Gurau. Okeylah go macam tu.
Oh, macam ni tukar minyak transformer lah korang. Tengok tu. 17.
Dia pas juga Cik Azmi, dua-dua pas. Cuma Shell lagi better sebab kalau fail dia lebih pada 50.
So
no, mungkin kita boleh
kan. So dua-dua lower than threshold.
Yeah. Tapi kita cakap Shell is much more better, then kita boleh Shell lah, the better one lah.
Okay, sebab during the life of the transformer oil, it will continuously absorb moisture from the atmosphere. Jadi kalau you start dengan 17, lambat sikit sampai 50. Kalau you start dengan 25, cepat sikit sampai 50. Itu je.
Betul.
Cepat kan? Lagi nak kena tukar.
Cepat sikit sampai 50. Yes, betul.
Tinggi maintenance.
So okay kot. Ada tambah air. The result shows that Shell has a lower moisture level which is better than Hyrax.
Kita just...
Macam mana?
Ya, kita...
Hi, Panasha. Welcome back.
Hi.
Nampaknya kita ada bos baru dekat Khazanah. Just announce. Okay, siapa nak post to the head box? Okay, please post your... Apa tu, your document to the chatbox. Tak siap pun tak apa, it's okay.
Crashed.
Kalau betul-betul nak tunggu siap, esok pagi tak siap. Okay. Dekat tu dekat chat box. Ada butang itu tak butang?
Tak ada butang.
Baik.
Oh, butang.
Ah, tu ada.
Saya tak boleh, macam mana nak share dia? Dekat chat box. Lepas tu
ada share. Ada butang tu kan, butang file kan?
Ada
boleh
lah kat sini ni.
Boleh drag je masuk dalam situ.
Oh, boleh drag je.
Daripada folder, drag masuk.
Okay.
And please connect. Jadi, okay. Did you get my document?
Yes, yeah, man. Saya tak tahu which one saya tak tengok ni. Okay, good. Group 4, yeah? Okay, transformer or testing. Objective. This quality analysis is to compare the quality. This quality analysis is to compare the quality. Mestilah, takkanlah the quality, this quality analysis is to compare the taste of the two brands. Tak kan? Jadi, kita dah ada quality tu. Tak payahlah kita quality kat depan. So this one we straight away say this analysis to compare the quality of two brands of transformer oil. Transformer oil. For decision of management. Okay. Actually, you are conducting this because you have been instructed by the management, right? Okay, so as instructed by the management. As instructed by the management. Okay, very good. So far, so good. Parameters to be tested: moisture content, dielectric breakdown, color index. Testing justification. Oh, good. Yeah. Moisture content in the transformer oil cannot be more than 35 ppm to prevent the flashover of the transformer due to moisture in the transformer oil. Jadi kau copy paste ke apa ni? Copy paste eh? Group 4. Ke group 5. Group 4. Hello group 4. Hi group 4.
Tak bincang.
Bincang eh, bukan copy paste eh. Okay, good.
Kan.
Very good. I like the language. Okay, dielectric breakdown has to be higher than 35 kilovolt dielectric strength as per minimum standard. Okay, sekarang kita kata dah dielectric. Jadi ini tak payah repeat lah. Higher than 35 kilovolt. 35 kilovolt strength as per minimum standard. Okay, tak payah ni eh. Color of the transformer oil is done through visual inspection. And it is considered polluted when the color index is more than 5. Okay. So now, tengok sini eh. Everyone look here. Color of the transformer oil is done through visual inspection. So this is a complete sentence. Complete sentence. Saya tanda dulu. It is considered polluted when the color index is higher than 5. This is the second complete sentence. Yeah, and you are joining these two complete sentences using the phrase and, conjunction and, kata sendi and. Yeah, so the rule is for punctuation, for comma, when you are joining two complete sentences using the word and, then you need to put a comma before the word and. Macam ni. So this is one of the questions earlier this morning, yeah. Okay, so this is one of the questions earlier this morning. So comma. Okay. After you join two complete sentences using the conjunction and. Right. Later I will explain some more, if not tomorrow. If not today, tomorrow. Transformer oil samples to be sent to accredited laboratory for testing, and it shall be tested according to ASTM standards. There are two brands to be tested in this testing, which are Hyrex and Shell. This is because both of these brands, both of these, dia bukan THIS, pasal dua. Dua brand. Jadi dua brand, THESE. Because both of these brands are having better quality in terms of the stated parameters above compared to other brands available in the market. Betul ke? Mana other brands?
Brand ni yang good. Kita nak pilih.
Ya, betul.
Assume.
Because both of these brands are having better quality in terms of the stated parameters above compared to other brands available in the market.
Hmm.
Did you test other brands? Macam tak ada kan?
Tak ada.
So are you assuming?
Check.
Jadi yang ini salah ni. Salah ni eh. So I cancel eh. Jadi sini pun kita rasa this is because both of these brands, both of these brands are having better, quality in terms of the stated parameters. Okay. Stated ataupun in terms of the three parameters. Atau tiga boleh eh. Three eh. Okay, testing criteria, unit, apa semua dah ada dah. Plus, minus, one. Okay. Siap dengan tolerance level lagi. Okay, based on the testing result from the accredited laboratory, it can be concluded that Hyrax is having better quality compared to Shell Transformer Oil, as the moisture content of Hyrax is lower than Shell Transformer Oil for, bukan for 8 ppm at. Ini at eh, bukan 4 eh, at. At 0.8 ppm, while the dielectric breakdown is 2 kilovolt higher than Shell. For color index, both are clear solutions. Both samples are clear. Both samples are clear as both of them are new because they are new transformer oil, therefore it is recommended to purchase Hyrax transformer oil. Therefore, it is recommended to purchase Hyrax transformer oil. Okay. So based on the testing result from the accredited laboratory, it can be concluded that Hyrax is having better quality. Okay, jadi sini, transformer oil samples to be sent. Actually, when you report, dah hantar ke belum? Group 4.
Has been sent. Dah hantar.
Kalau dah hantar tu, okay. Jadi yang ini, had been sent. Telah dihantar.
Had been sent.
Telah dihantar. Sent to an accredited laboratory for testing. And was tested. Okay, it shall be tested. Benda tu dah berlaku. Shall be tested akan diuji. So, benda tu dah berlaku. So, was. So, were. Dua eh. So, were
tested.
Tested according to ASTM standard. Tak ada eh. Okay. Both of these brands are having better quality in terms of both of these brands exceed the parameter for exceed the three parameters. Both of these brands exceed melebihi eh. the three parameters. Okay, bagus. Tepukkan, tepukkan. Okay, so once again, you must be careful. Yang mana satu yang kita laporkan, yang mana satu yang kita belum buat lagi. Ha, jadi yang laporkan tu kena dalam past tense. Okay, so ada tukar kepada past tense. Sebab itu kita dah buat. Okay. Okay, yang ini result tu pun dah past tense kan? Result tu pun dah berlaku kan? So Hyrex was having better quality, or Hyrex had better quality. Lagi senang. Hyrex had better quality compared to Shell transformer oil, as the moisture content of Hyrex was lower than Shell transformer oil at 0.8 ppm, while the dielectric breakdown is 2 kilovolt higher than Shell. Okay, both samples were clear. Master two, yeah, because they were therefore it is recommended to purchase Hyrex transformer oil. Okay. Ataupun another phrase that you can use is therefore, another one will be okay, therefore we recommend that top management purchases Hyrex. Therefore, we recommend that the top management purchases Hyrex transformer oil. Okay, close. Okay, jadi be careful with the past tense, be careful with the present tense. Yeah, benda yang kita lapor, benda dah berlaku, kita dah dapat, kita terima, kita dah buat dan sebagainya. Itu semua kita guna past tense. Yang kita buat masa tu baru kita nak buat, itu kita gunakan present tense. Okay? Okay, very good.
Cik Azmi, nak tanya. Hello. Biasanya saya pernah baca kalau teknik, kalau academic report dia elakkan guna we dengan I ataupun first person punya pronoun. Untuk technical report boleh?
The rules are relax a bit. Okay, the rules are relax a bit. So tengok ni, yang ini pun saya kata boleh terima. Yes, therefore it is recommended to purchase Hyrex transformer oil. Tu satu versi. Satu lagi versi, saya guna versi yang ini. Therefore we recommend that the top management purchases Hyrex transformer oil. Okay. The rules are relaxed a bit technical report writing. Sebab it is, you are not writing a thesis. And the other thing is, kalau kita guna ganti nama pronoun, kita guna we, jangan guna I. So it was a team effort just now kan. So it is not that I recommend, tapi we recommend. Okay, we recommend because you are representing your group, your department. So we recommend that top management purchases Hyrax transformer oil. Okay, have I answered your question?
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so we do one more and then we call it a day. Yang lain tu kita simpan untuk esok ya. Okay, so assignment 2, group number 5, Dr. Low. Okay, Dr. Low. Hang on ya.
Jasmine, saya nak tanya.
Okay, saya.
Conclusion dengan recommendation kena buat sekali ya? Tadi bukan kata body je ke?
Memanglah, tapi dia dah buat dah.
Oh, okay, okay, okay. Saya takut sebab saya tak buat.
Tak apa, tak apa, tak apa. Diorang advance, diorang dah buat lah. Okay, okay. Terima je lah. Okay. Okay, Dr. Low. Kita tengoklah Dr. Low and Hanif eh. Okay, dah ada dah. So new share. Can you see the screen?
Boleh, boleh.
Boleh, yeah, can you see the screen eh?
Ada, ada. Okay. Ada.
So we'll go to the screen straight away, okay? Okay, Dr. Low. The TNBR management considering to purchase from two brands of transformer oil. The TNBR management is considering. Or was considering. Dah berlaku eh? Okay, ASTM standards methodologies were applied to determine the performance of two transformer oil brands at TNB Research. Bukan in ya, nama khas. So ini kita gunakan at TNB Research. TNBR has set testing parameters for transformer oil as per table below. Table 1 below. Okay. TNBR had sent the transformer oil to the external accredited transformer lab. 2N external. To an external accredited transformer lab to test the oil quality based on the transformer oil requirements. Based on, based on transformer oil requirements. Okay, jadi yang ini kita bukan guna past perfect, kita guna present perfect tense. Yeah, present perfect tense because you are not reporting what someone has said. Okay, later we have time, we can discuss that. Yeah, later means tomorrow. Okay, so the reports of the test data are summarized as per table 2 below. Parameter, standard, moisture, flash point, dielectric, Hyrax, fail, pass, pass. Shell, brand shell, pass, pass, pass. Conclusion. Based on the test results from the accredited lab, TNBR has identified that transformer oil from Ben Shell has passed. The transformer oil from brand Shell had passed all the tests. Transformer oil from brand X has failed. Or failed to us, failed the moisture content contest. Therefore, it is recommended to the TNBR management to purchase transformer oil from brand Shell. From Shell je, tak payah brand lah. Okay, any question? Any question? Ada tak? No question. Okay, no question. Okay, no question. Then I would like to take time and then take time to look the difference between past tense and present perfect tense. Pula eh. Ah, okay. So, kita tengok sini eh. Look at these two sentences. So, in the first sentence. Okay. Kaide. Kaide. 8. Digoreng. So, Kaide ate nasi goreng last night. Tetapi, kenapa yang ini ate yang bawah tu has eaten? Can someone tell me why?
When it is past tense, you must put the time. When it is present perfect, the emphasis is on the action that he has eaten.
Raghavan, Mr. Raghavan, well done. Well done. Okay, tepuk untuk Mr. Raghavan. Okay, very good. Yeah. So look at the two. Okay, I hope you can understand. Yeah. Okay, yang ini, Kaide ate nasi goreng last night. I had light here last night, yeah. Okay, jadi yang ini pula also last night. However, last night ni is in the form of strike out. Okay, jadi yang ini kita strike out. Jadi tak ada last night. Jadi bila tak ada last night, kita guna dalam bentuk present perfect tense. Ini dalam bentuk present perfect tense. Okay, can you get it?
Why not use past perfect?
Past perfect lain pula. Okay, so past perfect tomorrow morning, I will tell you. Because time now 4:58. Unless you guys don't mind to spend a few more minutes with me.
Sure.
Esok dah lupa.
Tidak. Esok dah lupa. Okay, so a few more minutes, ya? Yeah? Boleh?
Okay.
Alah, duduk rumah pun kan? Duduk rumah pun kan? Okay, so yang ini past perfect test. So yang ini is in the form of past tense, eh? Past tense. Okay. So I will explain later. If you still don't understand, you can ask Mr. Raghavan to explain to you because he also know the reasons. Okay. So past tense, eh? Okay, let me show you, yeah. Okay, so yang ini is past perfect tense. Okay, so Kaide had eaten, okay, nasi goreng jadi yang ini pula ada dua tenses. Yang satu tu I'm highlighting here in purple is in the form of past perfect tense. and the one that I have highlighted here in yellow is past tense. Okay, now, what can you see from here? What can you see? What can you tell? What can you tell? Okay, in this case, two things happened in the past. Two things happened in the past. One happened earlier, another happened later. Which one happened earlier? Makan watch nasi goreng ke watch movie?
Nasi goreng.
Makan.
Makan dulu. Jadi yang makan tu, kita gunakan past perfect tense. Okay, so past perfect tense. Makan dulu. So makan tu lah past perfect tense. Okay. So past perfect tense. Okay, sebab dia makan dulu, kemudian dia tengok movie. Tapi dua-dua happen in the past. Dua-dua dah berlaku. Okay, dua-dua dah berlaku. Okay.
Kalau dua-dua guna past tense, Kaideh ate nasi goreng before he watch a movie.
Salah lah. Sebab the rule says, okay, the earlier action must be in the past perfect tense. Okay, if you have two things happening, one earlier, another later, yang earlier ni kena guna past perfect tense, yang later tu kena guna past tense. Okay, tengok ni, saya tukar ni pula. Okay, Kaideh had watched. Jadi ini had watched. Okay, had watched a movie. Okay, a movie before he ate nasi lemak, nasi goreng. Yang ni ate pula. So if you change the position, you have to change the tenses. Yeah, if you change the position, you have to change the tenses. So let me summarize. So here, we know specifically when it happened in the past. Tahu? Bila sebenarnya ianya telah berlaku. Berlaku bila? Last night. Jadi kita guna past tense. Yang kedua, has eaten. Kita tahu dah berlaku. Tetapi tak tahu bila secara spesifik. Sebab tak diberitahu. Last night, last week, I don't know. Yang saya tahu, dia dah makan nasi lemak. Dia dah makan nasi goreng. Kaideh dah makan nasi goreng. Tapi bila? Wallahualam. Mungkin tahun lepas. Mungkin bulan lepas. Mungkin semalam. Tapi saya tak tahu. Yang saya tahu, dia dah makan nasi goreng. Present perfect tense. Yeah? Yang ini pula, past perfect tense. So, bila kita ada dua, satu berlaku lebih awal, satu berlaku kemudian. Yang berlaku lebih awal, kita guna past perfect tense. Yang berlaku kemudian, kita guna past tense. So, this is important because it indicates sequencing. So, for example, when you explaining your experiment, ataupun tadi pasal kita cakap pasal sampling kan, collect sample dengan apa tu, dengan testing. So Kaideh had collected the oil samples before he sent them to the lab. Can you see? Yang ini had collected. Yang satu lagi, he sent them to the lab. Okay, when we talk about past perfect tense, ada satu lagi yang kita kena belajar esok lah ya, past perfect tense. Okay, I'll give you the situation tomorrow. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so time to go. Okay, I know you're all very tired. Letih tak?
Letih.
Did you learn a lot?
Yep.
Yes.
Thank you.
Mesti awak semua ingat mula-mula ni webinar kan? Tapi in the end, alamak, kursus pula. Kena buat lah, kena tulis lah. Kena cakap lah. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I am very happy with your participation. I'm very pleased with your participation. Memang suka. Saya gembira dengan keterlibatan anda. Oleh kerana itu, saya dengan suka citanya mengumumkan malam ini tiada kerja rumah. Malam esok. Okay, I expect to see all of you again at 9 in the morning. Boleh tak?
Boleh.
Sambil-sambil tu, you nak baca yang NASA punya technical report boleh? Dapat tak? Ada tak I bagi you?
Ada
kan? Okay, ada bagi you. Sekali kan nota tadi dalam chat box satu tu. Oh. Okay, jadi saya pun ada bagi report daripada NASA. So you can look at the projects in the projects and you can look at them, look at the samples. So we can discuss some more, yeah? Boleh tak?
Boleh.
Thank you very much. Okay, guys.
Thank you.
For today. Okay, switch on your camera. Kita dah ambil gambar. Switch on your cameras. Kita ambil gambar. Switch on your cameras. Kita dah ambil gambar. Okay. Buat lagi gila-gila sikit. 1, 2, 3. Okay, tunggu. Kita ada dua skrin. Pasal banyak ramai korang eh. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Mr. Rakaver, senyum.
Tak nampak.
Tak nampak Mr. Rakaver. Apa ni?
Baca belakang dalam. Lagi cerah.
Belakang dah cerah. Okay. Okay, before we go. When I count 1, 2, 3, I want all of you to say together, seronok! Okay, get ready. 1, 2, 3. Tak cukup kuat lah. Tak cukup sungguh-sungguh lah. Macam mana ni? Satu kali lagi. One more time. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Terima kasih. See you tomorrow. Okay. Bye.
Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum.
Salam. Bye-bye.
Terima kasih.
Okay. Bye-bye. Okay. Bye, Kaide. Bye, Shah. Bye, Mr. Raghavan.
Bye.
Okay. Bye. Bye, Nurul. Apa Nurul nak balik ni? Okay. Bye.
No.
Okay. Bye, Puan Marina.
Discuss ya.
Ah, okay.
Lupa.
Okay. I'm here. Okay.
I can discuss ya.
Okay.
Tak ada rekod pun. Dah habis yang pun dia.
Yeah, okay.